Where'd you learn how to do that?
We're beginning for boys.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to Factuality. Today we are going to be talking about the biggest heists in history. In today's world of fast-paced technological development and heightened security, it's not uncommon to believe that big money bank heists are a thing of the past, especially now that cash is no longer king. Believe it or not, however, large sum bank robberies and jewel heists still occur around the world. As you'll discover here, pulling off a heist is not quite as easy as it appears in the movies. We count down the 10 largest bank robberies ever staged and tell you where the loot went. Securitas Depot Robbery, estimated heist amount, $83 million. The largest robbery in British history can be attributed to Paul Allen, a cage fighter known as the Enforcer. Allen, along with a handful of other fighters, began the first phase of the heist posed as police officers and pulled over the manager of the Securitas Depot, Colin Dixon, who they held hostage along with his family. Using the family as collateral, the robbers locked the Dixon family and other employees in the vaults while they socked away the cash. At least 10 people were involved in this heist, which took 8 months to plan. Arrests were made soon after the event, thanks to DNA evidence and a messy trail of getaway vehicles. The biggest break in the case came when a digital recording was found by police on the cell phone of one of the accused robbers, the plot being reviewed at length by Allen. More than 15 people were arrested within the following year, with $25 million recovered. The Pink Panthers, estimated heist amount, $108 million. When an international team of jewel thieves went on a spree of break-ins and heists around the world, Interpol dubbed them the Pink Panthers after the famous movie series. From Switzerland to Germany, France and Japan, even Kim Kardashian claimed to be a victim of the notorious jewel thieves, though that turned out to be a publicity stunt. One of their most famous heists was when four men dressed as women entered the Harry Winston jewelry store in Paris, where there were jewels worth more than $105 million. The thieves were apparently familiar with the building and promptly cleaned out the rear stock rooms as well. The group made a clean getaway without a single gunshot fired. The mastermind of the robbery was Douadi Yaoui, who had just been released from prison owing to similar heists. Yaoui was arrested after some of the stolen gems were found in his home. Although much of the loot was never recovered, a plastic container hidden within cement and mortar containing $22 million in jewelry from the heist was discovered in a nearby Paris home. If you like the video so far and would like to see similar content in the future, then please hit the like and subscribe button. It's that simple. Trust us to always provide you with new quality content on trending subjects worth talking about. No fluff, just facts. So subscribe. We'd love to have you be part of our channel and make it grow. Now, back to the list. The Knightsbridge Vault Robbery, estimated heist amount, $97 million. Perpetrated by Italian playboy and career criminal Valerio Ficci, who was implicated in over 50 different bank robberies during his lifetime, the execution of this operation was surprisingly simple. After entering the bank during business hours under the guise of opening a safety deposit box, he and his armed accomplice subdued the manager and security guards, freeing them up to let in more accomplices to help bust open as much of the vault as possible. Eventually, they walked out with at least £62 million in cash, jewelry, and other valuables. Ricci enjoyed a brief period of freedom by fleeing to South America, only to be intercepted by British authorities and jailed when he came back to visit England in order to retrieve and ship his Ferrari Testarossa. Antwerp Diamond Heist, estimated heist amount, $138 million. On a Monday morning in 2003, concierge Jorge Diaz de Souza made his way two levels beneath the Antwerp World Diamond Center. What did he discover? The lights on, the vault and safe deposit boxes wide open, and millions of dollars worth of contents scattered among the floor. Missing! Approximately $100 million worth of diamonds, gold, silver, and other valuable types of jewelry. Nota Bartolo generated rapport with the security staff, which allowed him access to the vault. Over a series of months, the thief had minuscule cameras and wireless transceivers about the vault and vault entrance to capture the sequence of codes needed to open the 3-foot-wide door. A team of masterminds worked to disarm the other protective technology. A master locksmith called the King of Keys made a replica of the vault key, and another burglar managed to evade the magnetic door device, allowing them entrance. They forced open more than 100 safe deposit boxes and stole their contents. No alarms had been triggered and authorities would not be notified until the following Monday. The team stopped before the Italian border to burn their trash in a field, but one of the accomplices left some evidence, including a partially eaten salami sandwich, which led authorities back to Nota Bartolo. Although he has not been convicted of the crime, he was arrested and imprisoned for his association with this crime and others. The majority of the valuables were never recovered. Fun fact! Did you know in the 1980s, Pablo Escobar smuggled 4 hippos into Colombia for his personal zoo? Escobar's private zoo was home to some 200 animals, including elephants, ostriches, zebras, camels, and giraffes. Many of the creatures were smuggled into the country aboard Escobar's drug planes. After his death in 1993, most of the animals were transferred to zoos. However, 4 hippopotamuses were left behind. They soon multiplied, and by 2016, upwards of 40 lived in the area. The potentially dangerous animals have damaged farms and inspired fear in locals. Authorities began castrating male hippos in an effort to control the population. Now, the escaped hippos and their 80 descendants are wreaking havoc on northern Colombia's ecosystem. And ecologists say the oversized problem is only going to get bigger. The Collar Bomb Bank Robbery, estimated heist amount, $250,000. Now this one may sound familiar to anyone who's seen 30 Minutes or Less, but the real story is far more tragic. In 2003, a middle-aged pizza delivery man walked into a bank, handed the teller a note asking for the money in the vault, and then lifted his shirt to display a collar bomb around his neck and chest. After stealing the money, he got about 15 minutes away before state troopers arrested him. He started screaming that he had been forced to perform the robbery and the bomb was going to go off. The police surrounded the area and waited for the disposal squad to arrive. But before they could get there, the bomb started beeping and blew up. The tale only gets stranger from there, with FBI investigators, a long paper trail of clues, and dead bodies hidden in freezers. Here is a hilarious heist incident for you. A would-be bank robber threatened to file an official complaint after finding a bank in Springutsbury Township, PA, had no cash on hand. 48-year-old Joseph Getz allegedly attempted to rob a Susquehanna bank branch office in the town shortly after it opened. But after learning that the bank had no cash on hand to give him, Getz fled the scene while vowing to file a complaint with bank managers, police alleged. A bank customer who had been using the site's drive-thru services allegedly noticed the would-be robber fleeing the scene and followed Getz as he left in his car. The unidentified customer called the police, who stopped Getz's vehicle and arrested him on suspicion of attempting to commit a robbery. We are almost at the end of the list with the best yet to come, so keep watching! The Dar es Salaam bank heist. Estimated heist amount? $282 million. For a theft that resulted in the heist of approximately $282 million, the Dar es Salaam incident in Baghdad, Iraq, received relatively little media coverage. The thieves clearly used the prevailing chaos in the city to perpetuate the heist on July 11, 2007. At the time, even the local police and Iraqi government couldn't agree on the most basic details. Local police said 2 guards pulled off the robbery, whereas the Interior Ministry suggested that 3 men were involved. The morning after the theft, employees of the bank came to work only to find the doors unlocked, the vault wide open, and the money went. There are a host of unanswered questions about the robbery, and to this day, no one has been arrested, and none of the cash has been recovered. Why did the bank have so much cash on that day, and why was it in US dollars rather than Iraqi dinar? The men likely had the assistance of the local militias, because there is no other way they could steal that amount of money and safely leave the city. To give you an idea of the utter carnage in the city of Baghdad at that time, a total of 18 people were murdered on the same day as the heist. As the Nazis proved during World War II, it is much easier to steal huge amounts of money in wartime than in times of peace. Whoever carried out the Dar es Salaam bank robbery took advantage of lax security and will probably never be caught. The Central Bank of Iraq robbery. Estimated heist amount? $1.4 billion. The largest cash grab in the world was pulled off by an extremely well-known individual, Saddam Hussein. Fearing the impending bombing of Iraq by US forces, Hussein used a basic system to ensure the protection of the government's money. He penned a handwritten note to the Bank of Iraq, which he sent with his son Qasai, in order to withdraw the entire vault. 3 loads of cash were shuttled back to the presidential palace, but due to Hussein's autocratic ruler status, it is hard to discern if any actual crime was committed. The international response, however, was an extreme concern. More than half of the cash was recovered from Hussein's palace by US forces, but the remainder is still unaccounted for and is assumed to have been spent on insurgency efforts and terror plots. Given the demise of both Saddam and Qasai Hussein, it is doubtful that the missing cash will ever be recovered, or its paper trail sufficiently traced. So that's all we had for today, and we hope you enjoyed it. Which one do you think is the most astonishing? Let us know in the comments below, and please remember to subscribe so you can become part of our channel. Until next time.